This conference will now be recorded. This conference will now be recorded.
So, identification of the anatomical site of the disease and the hemodynamic consequences. Differentiate stenosis from an occlusion. Determine the length of the lesion and very helpful in planning arterial interventions. So, angiography is a gold standard method to delineate the location and the nature of the diseases. It is an invasive technique. Access is usually via the contralateral common femoral or left brachial artery, and the risk of the technique is groin hematoma formation, retroperitoneal bleeding or back bleed, and pseudoaneurysm ruptures or formation of the pseudoaneurysms, and arterial dissection, that is two arteries. Within the artery, the wall of the artery is dissected. So computerized tomographic angiography requires ionized contrast, requires ionizing radiation, and produces an excellent picture. So this is magnetic resonance angiography showing the MRI image of the angiogram. So it is an excellent arterial picture, and it has no ionizing radiation, and it is non-iodine based intravenous contrast medium, rarely causes renal insufficiency or allergic reactions. So 10% of patients cannot utilize MRI because of if they enter the MRI facility, they will be claustrophobic, and if they have any pacemaker, they are contraindicated. In case of obesity also, it is not commonly used. So gadolinium used in individual with an EGFR less than 60 ml per minute has been associated with nephrogenic systemic fibrosis and nephrogenic fibrosing dermopathy. So evaluation. How do you evaluate? So this is not that much of importance to you. So I am gonna skip this part. Coming to treatment. So prevention. Primary to prevent wounds, that is addressed to serial patient care visits. A patient is asked to serially come and visit the hospital facility or the doctor so that we can monitor the size of the wounds. And secondary is to prevent atherosclerotic events, that is day-to-day habits, that is smoking cessation, and if there is any blood pressure, hypertension, controlling of the blood pressure by antihypertensives, and if this hyperlipidemic, then we give lipid lowering agents, and then antiplatelet agents, that is prevent the aggregation of the platelets in the vessels if there is any thrombus. Okay, if there is any thrombus also, we give for heparin, we go for antiplatelet warfarin therapies. And wound care, underlying infection should be treated first, and necrotic tissue always should be debrided. Later, basing upon the type of debridement or extensive debridement, then we go for tissue graft or skin graft. Okay, topical therapies with recombinant growth factors and hyperbaric oxygen are being investigated. That is, giving more level of oxygen supply to the tissues can also increase the wound healing. So when it is confirmed, so when the candidate is for revascularization, imaging, that is duplex or angiography, MRI and CTA, then revascularization can be done. So if the candidate is not suitable for revascularization, then we control the pain first and lesions, then medical treatment. If the patient is not responding to treatment also, then it is intolerable pain and there is spreading type of infection, then we go for amputations, that is basing upon the situation of the gangrene or necrotic changes below the knee, above the knee, or below the ankle, or above the ankle, or confined to the toes, okay, or the metatarsals. So what is the medical therapy? First we go for the treatment, is treatment of myocardial infarction and treatment of stroke, dyslipidemia, that is if there is any statin therapies, or gem fibrosis, and hypertension, as we have described, antihypertension, that is beta blockers, ACE inhibitors, and diabetes, that is proper food care, skin lesions and ulcerations should be addressed urgently. The HbA1c is less than 7%. So, chemical sympathetic, that is using of chemical agents or the chemical drugs to cut off the nerve supply or the sympathetic supply to the lower limbs. It acts by producing vasodilation of the blood vessels of the lower limbs. So what is the therapy? What is the chemical used? 5 ml of phenol in water is injection beside the bodies of the L2, L3 and L4 vertebra. That is within the spaces, L2, L3, L4 spaces. The effect of the drug can be judged immediately by feeling the warmth of the feet. So it immediately cuts off the somatosensory supply. That is, the patient will have warmth in the feet. It helps in healing of the ulcers and may improve rest of the pain, probably by interfering with afferent sensory circuits. So what is the surgical treatment? Amputation and revascularization. Okay. When do we do amputation? In case of irreversible damage to the limbs, or if the patient is having, if the patient is not able to stabilize even on revascularization techniques, or if the patient is having continuous chronic pain, then we go for the amputation. So in case of tissue loss with infection, an immediate decision regarding the need for amputation prior to revascularization must be made. So it is an irreversible process. Once the limb has been amputated, it cannot be attached again. So we have to carefully assess whether the patient requires amputation or not. So need for revision is common. So after, even after amputation, sometimes revision amputation is required. So lengthy process, recovery process, and prolonged hospital stay. So the patient stays up to one month or 2 months, so that basing upon the blood supply or recovery of the blood supply to the lower limbs, then we go for the discharge of the patient. So what is the risk we have spoken earlier, that is 5 to 10% in BK and 10 to 50% in AK. So on amputation only, we are cutting down the risk of mortality for the patient. So without amputation, the risk may be triple or four times the normal scenario. So what are the types of amputation? Below knee amputation, above knee amputation, rear amputation, and transmetatarsal amputation. Okay. What are the revascularization techniques? As we have described earlier. So when do we do revascularization? If the patient is stable and he can undergo, if there is benefit for him on revascularization, that is, if he can have better pain relief than amputation, then we go for revascularization techniques. So subintimal angioplasty, balloon angioplasty, stenting, and stent graft. So this is the picture representation of the subintimal recanalization of the patient. Okay, so canal is placed in the, one stent is placed in the vessel and recanalization is done. What is the future treatment? Drug coated balloon angioplasty. So this is the Lutonix which has been described in the picture. Okay, on endoscopy. What are the complication of angioplasty? That is, early is dissection of the vessel. That is, the vessel may be cut off into two. Within the vessel wall is cut off into two. You know, the arterial dissection. So there may be rupture of the vessel wall. And if there is any cholesterol emboli occurs, stent too long or too short covering the vessels can be are taken off. So what are the late complications? That is, stent migration, stent breakdown, intimal hyperplasia, and restenosis. Stenting types: self-expanding and metallic stents, SEMS. These are less radiable force and more flexible and can be dilated gradually, so maybe fewer dissections are done. And balloon expandable, stronger hoops, less strength, more precise deployment, and combined angioplasty with stenting in all cases, which might be beneficial. Okay. And upfront debulking size is not only safe but has now proven effective and may be best first approach to leave nothing behind in a patient with symptomatic disease. So lumbar sympathectomy. So chemical sympathectomy, we have discussed, that is injection of phenol with water in L2, L3 and L4 spaces. So lumbar sympathectomy is surgical procedure where we go for operative procedure same site, L2, L3, L4, with the lumbar sympathetic nerves are transected. This procedure may relieve mild rest and help heal limited area of superficial ganglion. Okay, thank you. Thank you.